I'm joined here tonight by a man who has made quite the impression on the WWE universe lately, Seth Rollins.
Kayla, thank you so much for having me.
Now, Seth, I wanted to get your comments on an act you committed against Cesaro a couple of weeks ago. What kind of explanation can you give for such a reprehensible act?
Let's give you more perspective on what we showed you earlier on. Cesaro was ambushed by an enraged Cesaro. Now, that's by Rollins. Cesaro was already hurt. He had an injured arm, and Rollins would attack the arm before going for a stop to Cesaro.
Cesaro tried to look past Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins has tried to decimate Cesaro, and it wasn't done there. Back at it, stomped Cesaro's skull on the steel. Man possessed.
Well, we've seen Cesaro under similar circumstances in the past, but he always comes back. He's incredibly resilient, and there's a good chance he could return.
I see what you're trying to do here, Kayla. I see the way you're trying to frame this interview. Please remember, I don't owe you or the WWE Universe anything. Certainly not my time or an answer to your leading question.
You're right, that's true, but that does not take away from the fact that Cesaro, as everyone knows, refuses to give up or back down. So, Seth, what happens when Cesaro returns to SmackDown? Thank you.